As the demand for alternatives to petrochemical plastics grows, certain biological polymers are emerging as promising solutions. They can offer similar properties while being biodegradable, biocompatible, and non-toxic. PHACOS is one example.
PHACOS is a functionalized PHA with POS groups in the lateral chains. This characteristic confers new and interesting properties, being the most described its antimicrobial activity against Staphylococcus aureus.
Promicon will optimize the current PHACOS production by using a genetically modified Pseudomonas putida strain to produce it from sugars, which are inexpensive and highly abundant in certain industrial wastes.
So here at the Institute, we have four biostatic big benchtop controllers for Staphylococcus, where we can perform two different fermentations simultaneously. We have two basal sizes, 2 and 5 liters. These units allow us to perform scale-up experiments and to study different processes and the production of high-value compounds on a larger working scale. During fermentation, we can control and monitor pH values, dissolved oxygen and temperature by means of probes that are in contact with the cellular probe. In aerobic fermentations, gas and air flow is connected to the tank, and with a controlled stirrer, we can achieve an adequate bubble distribution. Moreover, this outlet gas is connected to a gas composition sensor, allowing us to calculate different cellular respiration rates and to know the amount of CO2 produced during the bioprocess. So this way we can investigate further the bioprocess under study. During the experiment, we can add substrates and nutrients through these peristaltic pumps that are responsible for adding the solution to the tank. This way, we can extend the bioprocess and to achieve an improved yield and productivity results. During long fermentations, we can study the evolution of different parameters through this control software, where we can follow the fermentation on real time and remotely.
Promicon aims to make the PHACOS production process more sustainable by using CO2 as a carbon source. This will be achieved by developing a synthetic bacterial consortium with an optimized cyanobacterium, Synecococcus, that converts the greenhouse gas CO2 into sucrose using light. This sucrose then serves as the carbon source for the Pseudomonas putida to produce PHACOS. The next step in this trial is to scale up the experiments in stirred tank bioreactors.